All-American first aired in October 2018 and currently has a 92% rating on Rotten Tomatoes. You can tell that a show as famous and fabulous as The CW's All-American has to be packed with talent. The entire cast of the show has some fantastic performances apart from the show. So, what are the roles they've played in the past? Keep watching to find out. Firstly, let's rank the best TV shows about sports, aside from All-American. In fifth place, we have GLOW. A group of unemployed Hollywood women must compete in a wrestling match to have another chance at glory in the 1980s drama GLOW, which takes an unconventional but entertaining approach to the sport. By shedding light on other issues like class, religion, and racism, Netflix's unorthodox choice to make wrestling its main subject takes viewers on a beautiful journey. In addition, the comedy drama lightly touched on the realities of what it's like to be a working lady and an athlete. Indeed, the show's strong female characters are a standout feature. They consistently spark every scene's expertly crafted narrative. Allison Brie, Betty Gilpin, Sydell Noel, Brittany Young, Sunita Mani, and Marc Maron were among the stellar cast members of the drama, which lasted for 3 seasons. In the fourth position, we have One Tree Hill. One Tree Hill, which made its debut in the early 2000s, centers on two half-brothers who, though initially at odds, come to understand each other through their shared love of basketball, friendship, and romance. The drama series, set in the small town of Tree Hill in North Carolina, carried the audience through 9 emotionally charged seasons. It did so while maintaining the plot and covering a range of subjects. Audiences witnessed the teenage lead characters become parents, cope with pain, and pursue their passions while consistently adhering to the original video game. One Tree Hill, starring Chad Michael Murray, James Lafferty, Hilary Burton, Bethany Joy Lenz, Sophia Bush, Lee Norris, and others, featured a clear storyline for each of its characters. In third place, we have Friday Night Lights. According to Friday Night Lights, football is a person's entire existence for some. Based on the 1990 H.G. Bissinger film of the same name, the drama series has won praise for its accurate depiction of Dillon, Texas, and its dedication to all its characters. The Dillon Panthers, one of the country's top high school football teams, and their coach Eric Taylor are the subjects of the TV program. Friday Night Lights dealt with topics including abortion, drug usage, racism, and the pressure to win every Friday night's football game, along with many other pleasant moments and occasionally tense events. Kyle Chandler, Connie Britton, Taylor Kitsch, Jesse Plemons, Amy Teagarden, Michael B. Jordan, Journey Smollett, and more well-regarded actors were part of the ensemble cast. In second place, we have Cobra Kai. Similar to GLOW, Cobra Kai was another intriguing sports-focused TV show from Netflix that had karate at its core. Cobra Kai allows William Zabka and Ralph Macchio to train and coach young students who compete in karate contests as the two sensei also continue their rivalry, reuniting them and kindling their love and passion for the martial arts. Cobra Kai, which takes the audience on a walk down memory lane while also having its own elements, creates a masterpiece and receives Emmy nominations, which is a big deal for a reboot show. Thus, it's definitely worthwhile to binge watch the show. Macchio, Zabka, Courtney Hengeler, Zolo Maridueña, Tanner Buchanan, Mary Mouser, Jacob Bertrand, Gianni DiCenzo, Martin Cove, and more notable actors are among the cast members. Ted Lasso is on the top of this ranking. Ted Lasso, unquestionably one of the top TV programs of 2020, centers on an American football coach who accepts the job of managing a British soccer team despite his lack of experience. With his passion and biscuits, he makes an effort to remain upbeat despite his lack of expertise. Because of his incredible performance, Jason Sudeikis, who plays the title role, has won over the audience's adoration. His persona is likable. He always chooses the right course of action after considering his past. He pays attention to what others have to say, and he always finds the best in others. He makes a great coach as well, with all these attributes in hand. Next up are the top 3 unpopular All-American opinions. According to Reddit, the competitive world of high school football serves as the setting for the All-American show, but it also explores a wide range of other themes, such as classism, rivalry, racism, and acceptance. The show's premise, the contentious choices made by its key characters, and the convoluted relationships on the show, to mention a few, all contain essential but difficult concerns that merit further examination from Redditors, who followed this well-liked TV drama. In third place, the best characters on All-American are not Spencer and Jordan. The characters that Redditors thought were overrated or lacked substance seem to be a hot topic. Surprisingly, the supporting cast of All-American, including Laura, Grace, Dylan, Billy, and Asher, performed better than the show's main characters. Jordan lacks depth, and Spencer is the protagonist you should want to support, but his hero complex gets in the way and is tiresome. As a Redditor noted, the primary characters on All-American, Jordan and Spencer, have been criticized for having egos and hero complexes as well as for their interactions appearing forced and phony. In second place, Billy and Grace should reunite. Reddit users expressed enthusiasm for Billy Baker and Grace James in their comments, with a Redditor commenting that they're secretly cheering for Billy and Grace to get back together. It's interesting to note that the primary relationships in All American seem to have received less attention than those that never materialized, like Olivia and Spencer. It's understandable why Redditors would want to combine their two favorite characters on All American, Grace and Dylan, as Grace is seen as a consistent, uplifting influence who always considers the welfare of her son, Dylan, and the community at large. In first place, Corey James was not a good father. Corey, the biological father of Spencer James, made appearances in seasons 1 and 2 of All American. After abruptly leaving his family in season 2, Corey left fans and Redditors with many unanswered issues. A Redditor expressed a range of concerns following Corey's death from lymphoma and the revelation that he was the father of Dylan. The Redditor stated because he was ill, writers excused him. They also stated that, in actuality, Corey devastated 3 lives. Because of his mother and Corey's marital problems, Spence would have been an ordinary boy without a father in his life for the majority of his youth if he weren't a football prospect. Next up, other roles you have seen All-American actors play. Let's start with Daniel Ezra. Spencer James, the central figure in All-American, is portrayed by Daniel Ezra. Ezra is a British actor who has appeared in several other films in addition to All-American. In the drama documentary Murdered by My Boyfriend from 2014, Ezra portrayed Joseph. Royce Pearson and Georgina Campbell were also present in the drama. Additionally, he appeared in the one-season series Undercover in 2016 as Dan Johnson. Next, Samantha Logan. Samantha Logan portrays the only Olivia Baker of All-American. Throughout her career, Logan has been in various movies and TV shows. She portrayed Tia in The Fosters on Freeform, and Nina in the second season of the Netflix original series 13 Reasons Why. We won't soon forget her versatility as an actor. She also has parts in the 2019 movie Polaroid, the 2020 movie The Empty Man, and the 2018 horror movie Truth or Dare as Devara Walsh. Thirdly, we have Michael Evans Behling. The list of roles played by Michael Evans Behling, who played Jordan Baker in All-American, is not particularly long. However, you may have already seen his face on TV, even if it wouldn't be much if we had one nickel for each time Behling appeared in a remake of the Cinderella story. It's nevertheless fascinating that it happened twice. Both the classic A Cinderella Story from 2004 and A Cinderella Story Starstruck from 2021 contain Behling's name. Next, Greta Oniogu. Greta Oniogu portrays Layla in All-American. You may have seen Oniogu in some of the other parts she's portrayed because she has been in the entertainment industry for a while. She played Soraya Duvall in the television series Heartland. She portrayed Tammy in the 2005 love story Fever Pitch with Jimmy Fallon and Drew Barrymore. Next, Taye Diggs. All-American's Billy Baker is Taye Diggs, but that certainly isn't the only thing about him. Diggs has played a range of various roles throughout the TV and film industries. Diggs played Harper Stewart in the 1999 film The Best Man, Andre in the 2005 musical romance Rent, and Benjamin in the film Brown Sugar. Diggs recently appeared in the 2018 romantic comedy Set It Up as Rick Otis, which also starred Glenn Powell, Zoe Deutsch, and Lucy Liu. The upcoming television series The Best Man will also feature Diggs. Next, we have Bree Z. Spencer's best friend from childhood in All-American is Tamia Cooper, known who Bree Z portrays. Bree Z has participated in a number of productions, including the wildly successful drama series Empire. Bree Z had the role of Frida Gatz in Empire. The program ran for 6 seasons before its conclusion in 2015, making waves in the mainstream media and in the world of black culture. Additionally, Bree Z played Winnie in 2017's Fat Camp and Denise in Down for Whatever. Cody Christian is next on the list. Cody Christian plays Asher Adams in the program and frequently appears in well-known works. First of all, if you're a fan of Teen Wolf, you might remember Christian as Theo Rakin. Christian played Mike Montgomery in the popular TV series Pretty Little Liars. In the 2013 parody comedy The Starving Games, he also performed the part of Peeta Mellark. Lastly, we have Jeffrey Hightower. Simone Hicks is a character played by Jeffrey Hightower in both All-American and All-American Homecoming. In addition, Hightower plays Lydia in the 2020 movie Loco. She also appears in the TV programs Private Practice and East of La Brea. And with all that, we've come to the end of today's video. Now you know where you've seen some of the show's actors. Which series would you like us to talk about in future videos? Let us know in the comment section. Please give the video a thumbs up and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.